earnings because there's too much at stake.
Some experts believe Black Summer's biggest lesson is global warming.
We must deal with the problem that's driving this. That is climate change. There's no question now.
While climate policy was beyond its brief, the report notes climate-driven natural hazards are expected to become more frequent and intense.
Unless we deal with the root cause of climate change, which is burning fossil fuels, we're not going to deal with the root cause of the problem.
One recommendation would likely capture the attention of farmers more than any other, a subheading entitled Supporting Individuals to Make Good Decisions. It allows greater freedoms and clarity when it comes to hazard reduction of property.
You should be able to look after your own property.
Robert O'Bailey, 7 News.
Sydney's Hills District, Upper North Shore and Sutherland Shire are on storm damage alert after those regions topped the list of insurance claims over the past year. The figures, released by NRMA, show Castle Hill leading the way with 331 storm damage claims, while nearby Kellyville and Borkham Hills were not far behind. St Ives came in second, 282 claims there, while residents of Caringbah and Miranda combined for nearly 500 claims. The insurer says storm damage made up more than half of all home insurance claims during that period. 7-Eleven has been forced to pay $173 million after shortchanging more than 4,000 workers. The convenience store chain was found to have been underpaying staff and covering it up back in 2016. The Fair Work Ombudsman today praised 7-Eleven for implementing high-tech systems to prevent any future breaches, while also revealing just how much they've been forced to repay. It is the missing link in our road network, and finally, the ribbon has been cut on the long-awaited North Connects. The $3 billion twin tunnels will open to traffic tomorrow morning, connecting the M1 to the M2. But some drivers are already slamming the high cost of tolls and the fines.
Close to a year late, the $3 billion missing link on the way in and out of Sydney's north. North Connects winds 9 kilometres from the M2 at Carlingford Hill to the Pacific Highway at Boorunga. The tunnel cuts out 40 sets of traffic lights and shaves 15 minutes from the Central Coast commute.
That daily commuter, over the course of a year, will get a week of their life back.
But it comes at a cost for cars at $8 toll each way. For trucks, nearly $24. 9 kilometre twin tunnels will allow drivers to bypass one of the city's most hated roads. But the truckies won't have a choice. From tomorrow, if they're caught by the new cameras along Pennant Hills Road, they'll be fined $124. Truck drivers say the yearly cost will be crippling,
roughly somewhere between $40,000 and $60,000, mate, just like that.
Rob Woolley from Mount Taringa are now forced to use the tunnel and pay the tolls up to 6 times a day to get to the city.
There are so many benefits for transport operators to use the tunnel, unless it's being sold to us. Why make it compulsory?
When 1 in 4 accidents on Pennant Hills Road involve a truck, we've got to take action.
The tunnel will open to traffic in the early hours of tomorrow morning. Cameron Price, 7 News.
Now, Angie Asmus joins us with a look at the forecast.